Top 10 beautiful tourist destinations that we destroyed. We are currently in the month of April. School is almost out, and summer is fast approaching, which means plenty of fun family summer vacations. However, there is a pandemic going around, forcing many people to cancel that vacation that you've been looking forward to for so long. So to make you feel a little better about missing that vacation, I'll be counting down the top 10 destroyed tourist locations that you can't visit anyway. More specifically, the only locations on this list are landmarks destroyed by only humans. This will be excluding places destroyed by natural disasters. So now, with that out of the way, let's get into the video. Number 10. The Notre Dame Cathedral. Notre Dame de Paris, referred to simply as Notre Dame, is the largest Gothic Aria cathedral in all of France. However, quite recently on the 15th of April 2019, a mysterious fire broke out within the chapel while it was under repairs. What makes this tragedy so perplexing is to this day, no one really knows who or what started the fire. Either way, Disney predicted it in The Hunchback of Notre Dame. Number 9. The Nahmal Pyramid. The Nahmal Pyramid is a 2,300-year-old Mayan pyramid. It was destroyed in 2013 by the Damar Stone Company, using bulldozers. Their reasoning for doing this was because they wanted the limestone that the pyramid was made from. In this case, the limestone from this pyramid was used to fill roads with gravel in a nearby town. Fortunately, the foul crooks behind Damar Stone Company got what they deserved. After an investigation, the excavator driver, the foreman, and two of the company's managing directors were punished with fines. Serves them right, honestly. Number 8. Antarctica. While this is not an extremely popular tourist attraction, it is still one that people visit. If you ask me, I do not know why more people aren't visiting Antarctica. Dangerous snowstorms, an average temperature of 14 degrees Fahrenheit, what's not to love? On that basis, even if you're a crazy person who would find that appealing, I would highly suggest not going to Antarctica, as it is slowly melting, making it increasingly unstable and unsafe. Scientists link this melting to global warming, which is considered by some to be controversial. Nonetheless, whether you believe in global warming or not, Antarctica is still melting, and it's probably our fault, because humanity is the worst. Number 7. The Great Wall of China. Now I can already hear you typing in the comments that the Great Wall of China is not destroyed. You can still visit it to this day. While that is correct, it's only partly correct. Two-thirds of the wall have been destroyed. Yes, it's not fully destroyed and you can still visit it, but over half of the wall is gone. The cause of this is just from it being overused. The Great Wall of China is one of the most popular tourist locations in the world, and over the course of its lifetime, it's taken a lot of wear and tear just from walking on it, as well as people taking small pieces from it as souvenirs. It does not sound like much, but over time it starts adding up. Number 6. Nelson's Pillar. Nelson's Pillar in Dublin was a monument erected out of respect to Lord Nelson. The pillar was built in 1808 and was made from black limestone. Unfortunately, it was considered quite controversial. Many people said it was a symbol of British imperialism. But the bigger issue people had with it was that it blocked automotive traffic. It was a bit of a lazy excuse, but it was enough to get the government to consider moving it. However, after debates regarding whether it should be removed, the pillar remained, leaving many people upset. In 1966, IRA groups succeeded in planting a bomb that destroyed the upper half of the pillar. Army engineers were forced to blow up the rest of the pillar 6 days later, judging it too damaged to save. To think that an entire landmark was destroyed because it slightly disrupted traffic. Number 5. Babylon. The ruins of Babylon were in present-day Iraq and have remained undisturbed for a while. This all changed in 2003 when the United States of America declared war on Iraq and invaded them. In 2007, it was confirmed that American armed forces had converted Nebuchadnezzar's great city of Babylon into a 150-hectare camp for 2,000 troops. In the process, the Ishtar Gate was damaged by tanks, and the brick pavement leading up to the gate was destroyed. The rich soil of the city was bulldozed to fill sandbags. Ever since then, Babylon has been considered to be archaeologically barren, as anything that could have been there has been destroyed. Number 4. Maya Bay in Phi Phi Island, Thailand. Home to a magnificent white sand beach, azure waters, and stunning towering cliffs, Maya Bay has seen a massive influx of tourists after being the primary location for the film The Beach, starring Leonardo DiCaprio. This popular tourist destination has had more than a million tourists visit each year. About 200 boats stop by every day to drop off the 6,000 tourists that visit, severely crippling the ecosystem in the area. The pollution from the boats, littering, and sunscreen have destroyed 90% of the coral reefs that surround the bay. As a result, officials have closed off the entire bay on June 1, 2019, saying that it's been completely destroyed. It is bound to reopen again for tourists in 2021, with hopes that the ecosystem is recovered by that time. Number 3. The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is possibly the most iconic Parisian landmark. Surprisingly, it was almost never even constructed at all. The public protested the structure before it was built, concerned over both the cost and fears that it would be an eyesore on the city's skyline. It was eventually completed in 1889 and was meant to serve only as a temporary fixture that would be dismantled after 20 years. But its value as a radio telegraph station ended up saving it from such destruction until World War II. While the Eiffel Tower never was destroyed, it came awfully close to it. When the Nazis took over France in World War II, General Dietrich von Choltitzby was instructed by Adolf Hitler to destroy Paris, including the Eiffel Tower. Thankfully, he disobeyed those orders. Historians still debate on the reason Dietrich did, as it sounds strange that he would disobey a direct command. One thing is for sure, the Eiffel Tower still stands strong. Number 2. The Colosseum of Rome. The Colosseum is among the best-known structures in the world, as well as being one of the oldest structures in the world. Due to this, the structure has been slowly falling apart. If that wasn't bad enough, it gets worse. In the 6th century, following the fall of the Roman Empire, the landmark was pillaged for building materials. It was not until the 18th century, when Pope Benedict XIV consecrated the Colosseum as a church. Ever since then, the Colosseum has remained untouched. Number 1. Jerusalem. The old city of Jerusalem, whose walls were also built by Suleiman the Magnificent, was taken by Jordanian forces during the 1948 Israeli-Arab League War. It is home to several sites of religious importance and is traditionally divided into four areas: the Jewish, Muslim, Armenian, and Christian quarters. It is alleged that 34 of 35 synagogues were deliberately destroyed during the Jordanian occupation, including the 300-year-old Herva Synagogue. Upon retaking the old city in 1967, Israeli forces destroyed what was once the Moroccan quarter. The old city became a World Heritage Site in 1981 at the request of Jordan. And there you have it. Those were our picks for the top 10 tourist locations we have destroyed. Have you heard of any of these famous locations? Are there any more important locations you think we missed? If so, leave a comment about it below. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure to leave a like, and remember to subscribe if you enjoy our content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.